Innovation is more important now than ever for the growth and survival of organizations. And organizations that are able to continually innovate are able to do so because they create a culture of innovation and learning. Now, culture is the way people think and act. So creating a culture of innovation means getting people to think and act in ways that consistently generates new ideas. And there's two main areas to creating this culture of innovation. The first is challenge, and the second is organizational design. So let's talk about challenge. We all know that necessity is the mother of invention. And we can either wait for adversity to create necessity, or we can create some artificial necessity on our own. Now, waiting for adversity is risky and definitely not ideal. So how do we create that artificial necessity? Well, this is something that I talk about in a lot of my other videos, and I talk about with clients at every level of every organization. You have to set challenging goals and objectives to get the best results. Now, SpaceX is a fantastic example of this. Elon Musk challenged the SpaceX team to send a rocket to space at 1/10 the cost of their competitors. In order to accomplish that goal, the SpaceX team had to come up with new products, new manufacturing processes, and new organizational processes. So if you want to generate a culture of innovation, the first thing you need to do is set a difficult mission, objective, or goals. But good goals aren't enough on their own. In order to create sustained innovation, you have to create a culture that supports innovation, or maybe more importantly, doesn't discourage it. Here's a few of the most important factors to consider when you're building a culture of innovation. Number one is your level of chaos. Now, too much order in an organization, which comes from processes, rules, and bureaucracy, will kill your innovation, but so will too much chaos. If your organization is out of control, your productivity is going to drop and you're going to be constantly dealing with difficulties and challenges. And that's going to leave you with no time to innovate. And that leads us to factor number two, which is time. If your people are too busy with their day-to-day jobs, there's very little chance they're going to spend any time on innovation. So that's why I recommend budgeting time at about 70 to 80% of capacity. Factor number three is resources. If people don't have the money and equipment they need, there's very little chance that they're going to innovate. Technology can also be a major impact on how much time people have and how easy or difficult it is to create innovation. Factor number four is support. If people feel like they have to battle to get something done, they're generally not even going to try. Now, that perception typically comes from either bad management practices or having too much or too little chaos in your organization. Now, all of these elements are influenced by your top-level management, the people you hire, and your organizational structure. And as you start to improve these things, you're gonna find that your productivity goes up, the level of quality goes up, and people start to get happier, which is a major win all on its own. If you'd like some help in building this culture of innovation, give us a call or shoot us an email. I'll also throw some other videos up on the screen that may help you out. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button and hit the bell to make sure you get the latest notifications. Until next time, thanks for watching.